here's the deal. They want to stay over there. There's a big hardwood ridge over there. Longbeard's over there. We heard him gobble what, three times. The hens, they yelped all morning long for the last 30 minutes. But they got real hens, so we're going to give them a break. We're going to come back about lunch, 1 o'clock. But in the meantime, we finna go rip some lips. We finna go kiss crappies. So y'all, stick with us. We ain't done. We gonna go kiss some crappie and come right back over here and get on that long beard after lunch when them hens leave alone. Alright, so we're back hunting. The fish just wasn't doing it. The water was too cold. Too many people out there, whatever. Wasn't happening. So we back over here on this turkey. I just called. I'm about 95% sure he gobbled just over this hill, probably another 200 yards up. We'll see what happens. Y'all stay with us. All right, well, we gave them about an hour, 45 minutes to an hour. Called up 7, 8, 9, Jake, something like that, I lost count. But it worked, and it worked quick. We didn't even have time to get set up. I called once or twice, and they come in just like they're supposed to. No long beard in sight. So, it is now about 1:05. We're about to head to another field and see if we can't get up on in there. And one day we're going to find a long beard instead of a Jake. Y'all stay tuned. same this morning. Just heard some hens. Just across the property line, probably 50 to 75 yards. It ain't but 7:40, so I'm gonna go over here and set up again. A different location. The direction I think they're going. Problem is, they're on my neighbor's property. And I can't cross property lines, obviously. So, for whatever reason, they love it over there. But we're just gonna give it a go. Alright, so I was coming to another spot that I can hunt, and I drove by his three little bitty fields, and I drove by, got two blowed up with about 10 hens in this field. I'm trying to make a move on them right now. I don't know if I'll ever be able to sneak up on them, but we sure gonna try. So just hang tight, ain't gonna tell them what's been happening. All right, well, unfortunately, had two hens bust me over there on that field. So where is another field? What prompted me to come to this field is from the road, I saw some birds on the other end over there, kind of that way. And I have gotten on these birds before in the middle of the day. It's about lunchtime right now, about 12 o'clock. I'm gonna piddle with them to about 1:30, maybe an hour and a half. Nothing happens. I'm going back to the first original spot this morning where all the birds are gobbling. So, they got about an hour and a half over here to show me something. I'm out of here. And I'm gonna go to my tried and true midday spot. So, motivation level is pretty low right now because this is day number 5, 6, something like that. Not consecutive, but about the 5th or 6th time I've been able to hunt. I'm gonna give these birds over here. I know there's some over here because I just passed them on the road. So, there's a ton of scratching right there. I know y'all can't tell it, it's light on the GoPro. There's a dust bowl right there. That dust bowl is pretty new. It wasn't here last time I was here. Anyways, so see those pines over there? That's where I saw them at, but on the other road. So I think they're in them pines right there. But I saw them sweating. They got hot. I saw them probably give or take an hour and 15 minutes ago on the other side of those pines. I'm 100% sure they're in those pines right now. But I don't know if there's any longbeards. All I saw was hen and one jay. So, might be a longbeard, might not. I don't know. But anyway. Got him, baby. Got him, baby. Yes, sir, baby. Got it. Good. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. We found it. Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Oh, man, what a run. It's been, I just be my sixth day hunting. Sixth, not consecutive, but sixth day total hunting. Little old 2-year-old. Got about maybe an inch spurs, something like that. They almost, they might let them hang. But anyway, all right. Man, that's a beautiful bird. So what happened was, I went hunting a whole nother area and I made a big loop and I come back around to this property. And I knew that they was on the other side of these pines. I saw them walking in them pines. And I thought, well, I got out my own X maps, looked at it. I called probably 5 times, never heard a sound, not a peep. And I was sitting there about to doze off, to be honest with you, about to doze off, and I heard pow. And that's when I knew, if a bird ever gobbles midday, there's a 95% chance he wants to ride in the back of the truck. Well, it finally all come together, didn't it? Ended up calling up 3 longbeards. He gobbled the first time at 12:05, I believe. And I pulled the trigger at 12:22. Pretty sure. Might be, give or take, 12:24, 12:26, somewhere. 12:20 something, I pulled the trigger. But anyway, it's always nice walking out a little heavier. So it's rewarding is what it is. Just can't thank the good Lord enough. He did make me work for it though, maneuvering everything. But those turkeys, like I shot this turkey at about, oh, couldn't have been more than 27 yards, something like that, less than 30 for sure. And so I couldn't do a whole lot of maneuvering with the camera, so I do apologize for that. But anyway, like I always say, we may not know what we're doing, but we out here, baby. Out here, outdoors, bringing it to you. Y'all have a blessed day.